Hello, friends. My name is Ogodino Uche Jude. Welcome to today's online class. Today's physics class, our discussion or the topic we are going to treat today is refraction through lenses. So before we fully go into details, what refraction through lenses and how they are applied in various ways, let's go through our lesson objective for today. So our lesson objective, by the end of the lesson, the student should be able to differentiate between convex lens and concave lens, draw various ray diagrams of convex lenses, draw ray diagrams of concave lenses, use mirror formula and magnification formula to solve questions on lenses. So lenses are curved objects or materials made from glass or clear plastic used for refraction of light. Okay, types of lenses. Lenses are commonly made of glass or clear plastic. They are widely used in spectacle, that is your glass, your eyeglasses, those that use eyeglasses for eye correction if you have short sight or long sightedness. Then for camera, lenses are applied in camera. They are applied in your projector, those projectors you use in your churches to project movies, telescope, and many other optical instruments. Our human eyes have two special crystalline lenses which enable us to form image. Our eyes have what we call biconvex lens. We talk about that in details much later. So type of lenses. The first one in the diagram is the biconvex lens, the planoconvex lens. The biconvex lens is made up of a converging lens. Then the planoconvex lens is like half of your biconvex lens. So this is like half. Look at the middle, straight. So if you join two planoconvex lenses together, you have a biconvex lens. Then we have what we call the concavo convex lens. The concavo convex lens is made up of a convex lens and a diverging lens or a concave lens, of which the convex lens is more curved inwardly than the what? That's the convex lens is more curved inwardly than the concave lens. So we'll go back to the next one, which is the diverging lens. The diverging lens is a lens that is thinner at the middle than at the what? At the surface. While the convex lens is thicker at the middle than at the what? At the outer surfaces. So this is our planoconcave lens. The planoconcave lens is like half of this what? Biconcave lens. Then we now have the convex, so concave lens, made up of the convex lens on one side. So this is your convex lens on one side, the outer side, and your concave lens inside. The concave lens inside, you can see, is what? More bent inwardly than the convex lens outside. I mean, at the other side. So one side, convex lens, the other side, concave lens. So the converging lens. The converging lens brings rays of light together. Diverging lens spreads out rays of light. So what is a thin converging lens? A thin converging lens is a lens that is thicker at the middle than at the outside, like we said earlier. Or a thin converging lens can be defined as a lens whose thickness is smaller in value when compared to its focal length, or where compared to its what, diameter. So any lens where the thickness of the lens has a smaller value when as compared or measured with the diameter of the lens itself is known as a what? Thin converging lens. So action of a converging lens on parallel rays. So this is exactly what happens on a parallel rays of light. These are the rays of light coming in this direction. This is like a laser ray of light or sun rays of light. When they pass through this biconvex lens, then look at what happened. They converge at this particular point. Convergence means that they meet at a particular point. Look at the first one. Passes through this place. Then it bends at this other point. that is refract, then come to meet this particular point. The same thing goes to the second rail. The only rail that does not bend on the vid is at the middle. Later, you know why they are called principal axes. Their names are called principal axes, so we'll deal with that much sooner. Now, action of a diverging lens on parallel. Look at this. It converges light. Diverging lens spreads light. So this is a diagram of a what? Converging lens. Much like the shape of a sharp potato. Then this other one is what is called your diverging lens. Diverging lens helps to what? Spread light. Diverge means to spread, to scatter, to diverge, to spread out. Why converging means to, if like, for example, you are asked to converge in a particular point, all the students in this class converge in a particular point, it means what? You should all meet at a particular point. So these are where the rays are meeting. And this is what we call a principal focus. They meet at a particular point called the principal focus. So moving ahead. Now, this is a ray diagram that actually describes all the properties of a what? Converging lens. So converging lens is also called convex lens, while diverging lens is also called concave lens. It is either thin or thick, but most times we use our thin converging lens. I will explain what thin converging lens means. We say anything that has to do with thin converging lens or thick, thin converging lens or thin diverging lens, it means the thickness of the lens is smaller than the value of the diameter or the focal length. Okay, moving ahead. The principal axis is the ray of light that passes through the center of the what? Of the converging lens or the convex lens. So the principal axis, any ray passing through the center is minimally deviated. The deviation is not noticeable at all. So in your diagrams, it is usually not denoted as what deviating, or no, the diagram will not show you that it's deviating because you can't really see the deviation, very slight deviation. But other rays that are parallel to the principal axis is what deviated, or they are refracted. So look at this ray, the first ray, look at how it's refracted. It meets at this first point, other rays meet at this point, and this point is known as your principal focus or the focal point. So this middle is what is called the optical center. The optical center is the what? The actual center of the lens. So the distance between the optical center and the principal focus is known as our focal length. The focal length is very, very important for all lenses. Different lenses have their own focal length. So in a normal class setting, your laboratory, you'll be given some method of how to determine the focal length of any lens, whether a convex lens or a diverging lens. If you're talking of convex lens, you know it's converging lens by now. And if you're talking of diverging lens, that should be your concave lens. So the middle principal axis, other rays that are parallel to the principal axis, they bend on passing through the, and that bending is called refraction. So they refract on passing through the what? The thin converging lens and meet at the point called the principal focus. So the distance between the principal focus and the optical center is known as the what? Focal length. So what are the other things we need to know? The focal plane. The focal plane is just a straight line that is what? Perpendicular to the principal axis. And the form, is perpendicular to the principal axis. And it must pass through the principal focus down to the point where they converge. So that is our focal plane. A focal plane is a straight line. Forms a perpendicular line to your principal focus. Okay. So we've explained all this on optical center, the center of the lens, principal axis, the middle, the ray of light, whether sunlight or any ray of light that passes through the center. We said it is very minimally deviated so that in that ray diagrams, it does not really show whether it is what deviating or not. So in ray diagrams, like I said before, you see them just moving directly. So principal focus. The principal focus is a point where all the rays that are parallel to the principal axis will converge. Then your focal length is the distance between the optical center and the principal focus. Then your focal plane is a straight line that's what's perpendicular to your principal axis. Now, a lens has two principal foci. So, what does it mean that a lens has two principal foci? A lens has two principal foci means in a biconvex lens, the ray of light might be coming from right or coming from what, left. So, if you are using a biconvex lens, that means the principal focus will be two. If it's coming from the right side, then the characteristics of the image showing can be at the other side, if that's the left side. So if the ray of light is coming from the left side, then the image or whatsoever you want to get might be because it's not in all cases that your image shows on the other side. Sometimes they show on the same side as the object and so on and so forth. So ray diagrams. An incident ray through the optical center, it passes through without bending. An incident ray parallel to the principal axis is refracted by the lens to pass through F. Any incident ray passing through F is refracted by, okay, this is what that place is talking of. If you want to draw your ray diagram now, look at the first ray diagram. First, the rule is the first ray of light passing through the object or from the top of the object we pass through the optical center without bending, just draw it straight. And the second one, from the top also, it bends after passing through the lens that you are using, which is like this diagram now is what, a converging lens or a convex lens, so it bends. Then if you are drawing it through the focal lens or the principal focus, then it is going to be parallel. The rays on emerging outside the lens is going to be parallel to the what, principal axis. So linear magnification has to do with the kind of image that is going to be formed when you use a thin converging lens or a thin diverging lens. So in a layman's term, it's just what, the height of the image formed from the object. So image are magnified, meaning they are bigger or they are doubled or tripled or so on and so forth, while some other image are diminished, meaning that they are what, smaller in size. So we'll see that much more later. So ray diagrams. So in order for us to really get what I've been saying, let's see how to draw some ray diagrams. So let's start with this ray diagram. Now, if you want to draw a ray diagram, the first case, this is your convex lens, this is your C, the optical center. Now, this is the focal length of this lens, for example. This is two focal lengths. So we said that a biconvex lens, this is a biconvex lens. Why? Look at this. If you take one plano convex and another plano convex, you join them together, what are you going to have? You have a biconvex lens. So that is it. Now, this other side, F2F. So the focal point or the principal focus is this. Now, 2F means what? Double of the focal point or principal focus. Now, if our object in ray diagrams, objects are usually represented with arrows. Image is also represented with arrows, something like this and this. So let's start with the first characteristics. If you have a convex lens now, for example, and the object is between your principal focus and the optical center, what is actually going to happen? Remember, in the rule of ray diagram, the first one is going to go like this from the top, and it will pass through this. Yes, then the next one is going to a straight line passing through this, it will not deviate. So look at what is going to form now. Extend this line. It's going to be a straight line. Then you have an image. So this is the diagram of the first one. So this is the object. Object. And this is your image. Now, if you look at this, this is the normal setting or the other side where your image is supposed to appear, but it's appearing on the same side of the what, object. So this is a rare case in a convex lens, and it only happens when the object is placed in between the focal point or the principal focus and the optical center, in between them. Then this is what is going to happen. We are going to have a magnified virtual image. Remember, we said that virtual images are those images that are what? That are not real images, because the ray of light are not actually passing through it. Look at this. This is an extended ray of light. The ray of light are not passing through the image itself. So they are visual image. Visual image, if you want to like take a photograph of visual image, they will not appear on the screen. If you want to even like, let's say, print them out, or the way you print real images, you are not going to get any picture, because they are not real images. They are like visual, means something that is not what? Not real. Not real. So this is a visual image. So when does this case actually happen? In a magnifying glass. Magnifying glass. So in that magnifying glass, when you place the focal length of the magnifying glass now, for example, if you go in between the focal length of that magnifying glass and you are looking through it, what are you going to see? You are going to see a magnified visual image. Image that is all magnified, enlarged. Magnifying means what? Enlarged. So that is the first case. So let's go through some other ray diagrams. This is the first case, case one. Case two is your convex lens, optical center, first point, focal point, this 2F. So because the ray of light or our object is here, and we are actually making use of the ray of light coming through this place, then let this one be prime. So this is our what? 2F. Now, remember the first case, the object was placed in between. Now, what if the object is on the principal focus itself? What happens? Draw this, then refers through the other points. That's the principal focus at the other side. And this one will always go through like this. Sorry, should pass through the middle. This is the middle now, so it passed through the middle. Mind you, all these things are straight line. So we have a parallel beam, parallel rays. Then, if you extend this, the image will be formed at infinity. Image formed at infinity. So, this image formed at infinity, the application is your spotlights, those spotlights used in prison and every other spotlights that when you have the biconvex lens and the whatsoever you want to use is placed at the principal focus, then what you actually have will be what image forming at infinity at a very far point, very, very far from the what viewing of the eyes. So that is where the image will be formed at infinity. So that's the second case. We said it's applied in spotlight. Okay, let's go to the third ray diagram. Optical center RF 2F, double of the principal focus. So at this particular point, F prime and so on and so forth. So this one, as usual, go through this way. Then this one goes through like this, passes through this middle. So hope you are learning how to draw these ray diagrams, because you will need them in your examination, your physics examination. You need to know how to draw them. So this is your F. Is actually the F prime. Then the point of intersection is where your image will form, and the image is upside down. So it's beyond your 2F prime. The image is beyond your 2F prime. So this is our image. This is the object. The image is formed at the other side, upside down. And images formed upside down like this are called real image. You can see that this time around, the image was not represented in dotted line, showing that they are visual image. If they are visual image, dotted line, but this is a real image. So real image formed, magnified or enlarged. Okay, what magnified? Let's not use magnified. Let's use enlarged. And it's beyond what? 2F prime. So this image that is beyond 2F prime, what's the application of this? This is applied in our projector. Our projector. So that is it. Going to the next one. F to F. F prime to F prime. So this one is applied in, remember I started from here. If you are moving the image to the principal focus, in between the principal focus and this one. So this, if you place it here, I'll remove this now because there's one trick I want to use in order to get it very directly. So leave this 2F first. This goes here, passes through this. Hope you are following the rules. The first one will deviate, the second will not deviate. Then this point is your 2F prime. So what do you notice? Image, this is your image, this is your object, this is the image. image is what? The same size, not magnified, the same size, and it's a real image upside down. The is a real image and is inverted. If you say upside down, in physics, the language is what? Inverted. The image is inverted. The image is the same size as the object. What's this one applied? It's applied in your photocopying machine, photocopier. That's why when you place anything in your photocopying machine, you get the same size as what you have done. So this is the application. Then finally, what happens if it is beyond 2F? F prime. So here, and finally, if it's beyond 2F, first, like this, second, like this, then 2F prime. So this one, what do you see now? This is diminished image. It's a real image, but it's diminished, meaning it's smaller and is in between F and 2F, not beyond 2F like the other previous case of a projector. So in between. So this one is applied. Your eyes is actually your brain that gives you the sensation or the feeling that the image you are seeing is what? Enlarged. But in real sense, the image that falls on your retina is actually smaller than what you are seeing. But the brain has a way of what's correcting it for us. And our camera also is take photograph. The people inside your picture, are they as tall as they actually depict or in real life? No, they are not. So that is how to draw your ray diagram. Hope you understand how to get your ray diagrams. So moving ahead, thin diverging lens. A beam of rays formed on the distance, you're passing through a diverging lens. Okay, you read that later. Action of the diverging lens on parallel rays of light. So this is the action of a diverging lens on parallel rays of light. The middle part is your what? Principal axis, then, and so on and so forth. We'll go shortly into the diagram. Okay, let's see the diagram of a thin converging lens. Let's go back to the board. So for a thin diverging lens, rather, is your thin diverging lens thinner at the middle than at the side? Look at how thin it is at the middle. This is the center. So this is the optical center. You can see nothing is actually happening. It passes through it. But other rays of light, like let's say this ray of light, it will diverge. Spread out. Diverging means spread out. Second one also was spread out. Unlike the other one that they were converging, this one will spread out. This arrow shows the direction. Now, this is our F, for example. Now, if you place object anywhere at all, let's place it here. We can place it anywhere in a diverging lens. Wow. So if you place it anywhere in a diverging lens, what happens to it? Let's use our ray diagrams now. This is the object. This will pass through this point. This is another diagram for this. Okay, like we were saying, let's not use the object now. This is what will actually happen. The ray of light will appear to converge here. This ray of light, this one will appear. Meaning, it was actually what manipulated to meet at this point. But in real life situation, it does not actually meet there. But this is where it should have converged. So if that be the case, then if you are going to draw ray diagram, only one ray diagram occurs or happens in what diverging lens. So let's see the ray diagram. So this is the thin converging lens. Principal has it. Your C optical center F. Let's say 2F is somewhere here. Then this is the image, whatever the size of the image. Let's make this one bigger. Okay. Right. So ray of light going through this point comes like this. Pass through that. Then the second one goes straight like that. So at the point of intersection, the visual image will always happen. So in all cases, anywhere you place your object in a diverging lens, this is the object and this is your image. Let's bring it out, image. So anywhere you place your object in a thin diverging lens, the case is always is visual. So it's not a real image, cannot be caught in a screen. Visual, diminished, meaning it's always smaller in size. So your thin diverging lens will give you a smaller image, give you a smaller image. So moving ahead. So lens formula, for both converging lens and diverging lens, the following lens formula applies. 1 over u plus 1 over v equal to 1 over f, where u is the object distance, v is the image distance, also f is equal to uv all over u plus v. Okay, let's apply. Example 1, an object of height 3 centimeter is placed 5 centimeter from a diverging lens of focal length 10 centimeter. Number 1, draw a ray diagram to determine the nature of the image formed. 2, use the lens formula to calculate the image distance. 3, use the magnification formula to calculate the height of the image. So I'll write out the question so that we can follow using the question. An object of height 3.0 centimeter is placed 5 centimeter from a diverging lens of focal length 10.0 centimeter. Number 1, draw a ray diagram to determine the nature of the image. 2, use lens formula to find image distance, V. So V is image distance. 3, use magnification. Magnification formula is M. Use it to find the height of the image, image height. You are looking for image height. Okay. So our solution. Our solution number 1, thin diverging lens. Optical center. He said an object of height 3 centimeter. Object of height 3 centimeter is placed 5 centimeter from a diverging lens of focal length 10 centimeter. So the focal length is 10 centimeter. The focal length is the distance between the principal focus and this. So small f. In case I didn't say it, big F represents principal focus, the point where they converge. But the distance between The principal focus and optical center, which is focal length, is small f. So our small f is given as what? 10 centimeter. Then the object is placed, an object of height 3 centimeter is placed 5 centimeters. So this is the object. The object from here to this place is 5. It's 3 centimeter, 3.0 centimeter. That is the height. But don't, let us not write it now. Now they said it's placed 5 centimeter from the lens. 5 centimeter from the lens. 5 centimeter. That is you. So when applying the lens formula, the distance of your object to the lens is known as u. That is what object distance is represented as small u. Then the image formed, anywhere it is formed, the distance of that image to your lens is called as what? Image distance, and it's presented as v. U object distance, u object distance, v image distance. So our image from our diagram. From our diagram, we said for diverging lens, everything is always a case. So let's do this now, like this. If we do something like this now, then that means you are going to extend this line. Pardon my manipulation, it's supposed to be straight. So we're going to do something like this, then this one goes through C, your image will be somewhere here. Image, visual image, so dotted lines. Okay, our image distance now will now be from this point to this point. V, this is my V, from this point to this point. So let's calculate. Our mirror formula is 1 over F, 1 over focal point, 1 over U, plus 1 over V. But this time around, because our image is on the same side as our object, then we are going to have a negative focal point. So we are going to put minus at this point. So that will give us minus 1 over F is equal to minus 1 over U plus 1 over V. So moving forward, can I actually clean this now? I'll clean this part so that I can still look at my question. So focal length minus 1 over 10, focal length F is minus 1 over 10, is equal to 1 over U, which is 5, 1 over 5 plus 1 over V. So this will give me minus 1 over 10 minus 1 over 5 equal to 1 over V. LCM is what, 10. This will give me minus 1. 5 here minus 2 is equal to 1 over V. So if I manage your space, 1 over V will give me minus 3 over 10. If you cross multiply or you invert V, if you take this one will go up, this one will come down, 10 over minus 3. So V will give me minus 3.3 centimeter, 3.333 centimeter. So the object distance, the minus is just to show that the image is what? Visual, and so on and so forth. So that is that for that. We've drawn the ray diagram. We've used the lens formula to find V. Now we want to get the what? The use M to get image height. IH means image height. All right, hope you've gotten this. So please, our V is what, 3.3 centimeter. I'll remove the minus because the minus is just showing me that it's a visual image. Okay, so let's get the last one. The magnification formula is given as image height over object height is equal to what? Image distance over object distance. Image height over object height, image distance over object distance. So M is equal to IH over OH equal to image distance is your what, your V. Object distance is your what, your U. So this magnification goes out. We use ordinary IH, OH is equal to V over U. So what is my image height? That's what we are looking for. What's the object height? They give us as 3 centimeter equal to, we got 3.3. as our V, image distance. Then our U is what? It's place, that's 5. So if you cross multiply IH will now give me 3 times 3.3 over 5, and you get your answer. So that is how to get that. This is a ray diagram. We've drawn that already. Okay, we've done all this. So our answer will now give us image height is 1.98. So let's see the second example. An object is placed 36 centimeters from a converging lens. Okay. Sorry. Excuse me. Excuse me. So, example two. An object is placed 36 centimeters from a converging lens of focal length 24 centimeters. If a ray image which is 4 centimeters is formed, calculate the height of the object. So our solution to this is, we don't actually need the ray diagram, but I'll just draw for this now. Let's draw the diagram. This is now a converging lens, not a diverging lens. So an object is placed 36 centimeters from a converging lens of focal length 24. So the focal length, our principal focus, this is the focal length 24 centimeters. Then the object, if this is 2F, which is 48, then 36 should be half of it. So this is where the object is. Object O prime O. That's what can be used to represent object. All right. So the distance is what? U. Object to lens is U, 36 centimeter. An object is placed for converging lens of this focal length. We've gotten the focal. If a ring image, which is 4 centimeter, is formed, calculate the height of the object. If a ring image, which is 4 centimeter, the image height. If a ring image, calculate the height of the object. Image height is 4 centimeter. Object height is what we are looking for. All right. So very simple now. Of course, our image will form somewhere here. So this is just to make you understand how to label the ray diagram. So our ray formula, or our lens formula, 1 over F is equal to 1 over U plus 1 over V. Now, the F is 24, right? So 1 over 24 is equal to 1 over 36 plus 1 over V. So 1 over V will now give me 1 over 24 minus 1 over 36. 1 over V is equal to, what's the XCM? 72. 3 minus 36 goes here is what? 2. So 1 over V will now give me 1 over 72. So if I invert, V will now give me 72 centimeter. So the image distance is what? 72 centimeter. But that is not what we are looking for. So we go over to our magnification formula. V is 72 centimeter. So that is what I need. So what's the magnification formula? U there. Yes, that's right. M is equal to image height over object height is equal to image distance over object distance. So M is equal to IH over OH is equal to V over U. So M So my M is equal to IH has been given as 4. We are looking for OH is equal to V. We got 72 all over U. What's our U? 36. 36. So removing M, cross multiply, OH is equal to 4 times 36 over 72. 36 here, 1, 36 here, 2 here, 1, 2 here, 2. OH is equal to 2 centimeter. So we're going to get 2 centimeters image. So this is it. Example 3. A lens of focal length 15 centimeter form an upright image 4 times the size of an object. Calculate the distance of the image from the lens. Okay. So, example 3, a lens of focal length 15 centimeter forms an upright image 4 times the size of an object. Calculate the distance of the image from lens. All right, so this one is very simple. The focal length solution, the focal length is what, 15 centimeter. The magnification is 4 because they said 4 times. So magnification M is 4. So calculate the distance. We are looking for V. Calculate the distance of the image from the lens. So we are looking for V. Our lens formula 1 over F is equal to 1 over U plus 1 over V. But from magnification equal to V over U, if you are using only that V over U side, which is image distance over object distance. So 4 is equal to V over U. Then if you cross multiply, what is our V? Our V is equal to 4U. So we can actually do that now. So we already know 1 over F, which is 1 over 15, is equal to 1 over U plus V is what? From cross multiplying 4U, which is 1 over 4U. So one over 15 is equal to XCM is 4U, XCM of these two. So U divided this, or 4U divided by U, 4 minus 1. 1 over 15 will now give me, is not minus but plus, sorry, 4 plus 1, which is 5 over 4U. If I cross multiply, 4U will now give me 75. U is what? 75 over 4. Right? Okay. So, calculate the distance of the image from the lens. Remember that we have what? U is equal to 75 over 4. So, how do we get V? V is equal to 4U. From what we cross multiplied? Is that not? So, we are looking for V. V is equal to 4 times U is 75 over 4. So, V is what? 75 centimeter. So that's our answer. So because the screen was small, I'm going to take this again. Let's go over it again. Our F is 15 centimeter. Our U And V was not given. U not given. V not given. But our magnification is what? V over U. Magnification, they said four times. So four is equal to V over U. We are only going to use that magnification side that is what? That has the image distance over object distance. So if I cross multiply, V is equal to 4U. So if V is equal to 4U, our length formula, 1 over F, 1 over U plus 1 over V, 1 over 15 is equal to 1 over U. What is your U? We don't know. Plus 1 over, but we said that V is 4U. So LCM, 4U. This divided by this will give us 4 minus, this divided by this, 1, 4 plus 1. So 1 over 15 will now give us 5 over 4u. Cross multiply, 4u is 75, u is 75 over 4. So, but they didn't say object distance. They said image distance. So our v, remember v is equal to 4u. V will now be what? 4 times, what did you get as u? 75 over 4. So V will give me 75 centimeter. It's as easy as that. So going back to so we got 75 centimeter. You can do it two ways. Then this is the last question for the day. An object placed okay, an object, example 4, an object placed 50 centimeter away from the focus of converging lens of focal length 15 centimeter produces image on the screen. Calculates the distance between the object and screen. So this is a pass Waec question. So, you know, Waec can be funny at times. You need to apply your wisdom. So you need actually need diagram in this to interpret whatever they are looking for. So this is this. An object placed 50 centimeter away from the focus of a converging lens. This is the focus of the converging lens. They said it's placed 15. This is the object. Let's say this is the object. Is placed 15 centimeter away from that focus, that principal focus of the converging lens. So F is 15. Produce image on the screen. An object placed 50 centimeter away from the focus. 50 centimeter away from the focus. And the principal focus itself, or the focal length, is what? 15 centimeter. So this is the object. From the principal focus to the object is 50 centimeter, but the focal length itself is 15 centimeter. Then there's a screen to capture the image at this point. Now they said this screen, calculate the distance between the object and the screen. So it's very simple. For you to calculate the distance between the object and the screen, this should be your U. Your U will now be addition of 50 plus this, which is what, 65 centimeter. Object to screen is the what? Object distance. Image to screen is the image distance. So V, image distance, we don't know. We need to calculate that now. So our 1 over F is equal to 1 over U plus 1 over V. Our 1 over F is 1 over 15 equal to 1 over U is 65 plus 1 over V. So 1 over V will give us 1 over 15 minus 1 over 65. So our V, or 1 over V, will now give us, what's the LCM of those two? LCM is 195, I think so. So if it's 195, then 195 divided by 15 should give us what? Let's look at the LCM first. LCM 65, 15. So that is what? 5. You give me 13. This will give me 3. This will give me 3, 1, 13, 13, 1. So 39 times 5, 5 times 9, 45. 3 times 5 times 9, 45. 3 times 5, 50. Yeah, 195. So actually 195. So 195 divided by 15 is 13 minus 195 divided by 65 is 3. So 1 over V will now give me 10 over 195. Oh, hope you are seeing this. Oh, I've made this thing again. I'm even going to repeat it. So, starting all over because I know you can't see with a small screen. So, using the big screen now, let's start all over. First, your lens, your C. This is your F. Now, they said an object placed 50 centimeters away from the focus. This is the object, 50 centimeters away from the focus. This is the focus, 50 centimeters. Then the focal length from the question is 15 centimeters. Then there's a screen here to capture the image, a screen to capture your image. So the image to lens is V. We don't know that. But we know U, this is object. So if you add these two together, you get 65 centimeters. So U, object to lens is your U, object distance, image distance. So using your lens formula, 1 over F, 1 over U plus 1 over V, which is 1 over 15, is equal to 1 over 65 plus 1 over V. That was what I was solving earlier. So if I use here, you won't see it. I need to clean this off. So cleaning this one, 1 over V will now give me 1 over 65 minus 1 over 15. Or 1 over 15, if it comes here, minus 1 over 65. So if you look for the LCM, you are going to get 1 over V is equal to 195. So this is 13. This one goes here 3. Then 1 over V will give me 10 over 195. So V will be 195 over 10. V is 19.5 centimeter. So if you look at the question, they said calculate the distance between the object and the screen. Object and the screen. So the distance is actually D is equal to U plus V. Adding from here to here, you add object distance and image distance. So our distance is U. What is U? 65 plus 19.5. So that will give us 84.5 centimeter. We'll get 84.5 centimeter. So that is the end of our class for today. With that, I hope you understand how to use lens formula, what a converging lens means, what a diverging lens means, why is it cutting converging lens, and so on and so forth. So to meet again in our next online physics class, I still remain Mr. Jude. Ciao.